that's all right. We're out here in the farm, we're having a good time. So this is our third barn smoker. And every year, it gets bigger and better, and I want to thank every one of you for supporting this farm and the project that we do and the cigars that we have. So, give it up for America, right? All right, so I wanted to first start off by giving a quick status or state of the farm. Normally when we come out here, the intention is that you walk out to the fields and the tobacco is chest high. Not everything always goes as planned when you're growing tobacco or doing any type of agriculture. So we had a little mishap earlier in the year where we inadvertently applied an herbicide in the spray tank that shouldn't have been there. We killed the entire crop, okay? So, we had to restart from scratch. Now, there was a lot of pressure because this barn smoker is planned well in advance, and the dates are set well in advance. I tried to tell the tobacco seeds, listen, you need to grow and be ready by the 19th. We normally need 60 days to grow, and we only had 45 days to do it. But, listen, sometimes things work out. The days get longer as the summer progresses. You get a little more sunlight, it's a little warmer, and our little tobacco seedlings listen. So we've got 70,000 tobacco seedlings over there. They're ready to go. We're planting in the field. We've been planting since Thursday. We're going to be planting today. So instead of this being a start of the harvest, it's the start of the new crop. Now, maybe this whole thing happened for a reason why the tobacco actually got killed, because I can tell you, when you look at the field and some people experience the mud with their cars, when the field is muddy like that, tobacco doesn't like wet soil, okay? So I'm hoping this rainy season that we've had for the last week has been terrible. It's rained every single day, heavy too. So hopefully maybe the rest of the season will dry out a little bit, because actually if we had tobacco in that field right now, it's probably gonna be dead. Now, a lot of people are worrying, hey, we're gonna have tobacco for Florida Sun-Grown cigars? Yes, we will. Even if we have a hurricane that comes on top of us in the summertime, which we may, we'll replant a fall crop. We've done it in the past, we can do it again. The season dries out as the fall approaches, and we'll be able to get our tobacco going. So, that was why I wanted to get that important information, because a lot of people are like, hey, where's all the tobacco? You're not gonna see it except in the little form, but you guys are gonna take part and help us out planting our crop. All right, next, I wanna, starting at noontime, we have a lot of different sponsors here to do. We've been making this event bigger with a lot of cool things that go on besides what we do with the tobacco. So I want to call off, we've got a lot of liquor vendors here. Inside your packs, you should have two tickets. Come noontime, we're going to open the bars. We don't want to open them too early because it's been noontime's when we start on here, right? But those of you know, John Drew's got a heck of a whiskey business going too. So in that corner, we've got the John Drew brands over there with the Brixton Mass Destroyer, the John Drew Rye, and the Dovetail Rum. Next to that, we have a Cowan Single Malt Scotch Whiskey. Right? Good stuff there. Brugal Rum, Partita Tequila, Highland Park Single Malt Scotch. We've got Knob Creek Bourbon, Maker's Mark, El Tesoro Tequila, Quack Beer, Triple Carbonate Beer, so the guys that want beer, we got that too. We got Ed Miarolin that came in from Hopkinsville, Kentucky, which is where the barn smoker's done, to the Kentucky barn smoker. So these guys made the trip down here. Matter of fact, they brought one of the farmers with them. We might trade some secrets. All right, Snow Leopard Vodka, and then also what we had cool, if anybody watches our videos that we do, anybody see that Hummer thing that we did with the machine guns? Dude, that's nuts. So the guys that do these crazy things with us with these machine guns are right over there. That's Machine Gun America. They're right here in Orlando where you can shoot fully automatic machine guns. You can Rambo it, do whatever you want. Not here, but at their place, all right? But we brought the girls that they have for their calendars. So they'll be selling calendars, and 50% of the proceeds go to our guys here at Scars for Warriors. And we got some cool prizes there too. So get your pictures with the girls over there. They got machine guns and everything will look cool. Next, you got some military looking trucks over there. We got some custom Land Rovers from Safari Heritage Parts. So if you got a Land Rover, we You want to make it look like you're ready to go into the desert and go shoot up whatever? These guys can do it. I don't know if they'll give you the M60 up on top of the roof, but you can take a picture of it, all right? Now, you got John Deere here, one of our equipment partners. If you guys do have a place where you want to cut grass like a professional, they've got the big zero-turn mowers you look at, got the state tractors, they got one of the coolest UTVs. If you buy it today, I'll let you go tear up the field there and go mud bogging if you want. But that thing is cool. It's got air conditioning, all-wheel drive, all that kind of stuff. So they're there for you to check it out. So we got a lot of different experiences going on for you today. Now, I want to, Big JD here, this is my best friend, partner. We've done things together for the last 20 years. I love doing anything and everything with John. I'm going to get my best thing away. All right? I'm going to turn it over to John.
Smokers before, you know about your estate, you know how we feel about our military service people, so that's first. Second, Jeff, the whole Corona team, thank you guys deeply. You guys have been great partners. Yeah! How about some of that love for Chris Ross for Warriors? It's been one of them. To all your employees throughout the last 20 years, you've done everything to build the true estate, you know what I'm saying? We really do appreciate you guys. So thank you so much, the guys from Corona and gals. Our team, of course, all the true estate team, everybody's here. Oh, they let him in? Holy shit! Jared. So, all the Drew Estate crew that's here, you guys, thank you guys from me to you guys. Thank you for always being there and for doing everything to make everything that we do illuminate the industry, have purpose in what we do, find a deep value in what we do, virtuous value. Love you guys. John Brands, Swisher guys, the food people. Floyd's Catering does a damn good job. Emmy Rowland, Diplomatico, Tijan Imports, Jim Beam, McAllen, Partida Tequila, Brugal, Machine Gun, American Posse, Matt Cain, Tuesday Night Cigar Club. You guys know that Tuesday Night Cigar Club? It's a very cool podcast. So check that out. All right. Got that covered. Except for one thing. I didn't thank you guys. Thank you guys very much for consistently year after year. Except for you, Katie Tom. Just kidding. Now, seriously. So, I know we got a lot cracking for today and everybody's ready to get going, so I'm not going to take too much time. But, jump back to the first bond smoker we ever did before there was a Florida bond smoker, actually. When we first started, it was in Kentucky, where we did our first bond smoker. I don't know how many years ago it was. I was thinking about it, 6 or 7? Who knows? How long ago was it that we did the first one? 6 years? There's 5 different fucking numbers showing up there. So 6 years ago, we did our first Kentucky bond smoker. And everybody was like, yo, Staten Island in the house. God damn, I know all of you motherfuckers. Shit. I know Louie and Michael, God. Yeah, Miami Mega Hurt. We're going to talk about that lunch day. So, when we pulled, yo, what's up, man? When we pulled off that first Kentucky bond smoker, everybody was like, listen, JD, you're crazy. We're busy right now. We're going to Europe. We got other shit going on. You can't do it right now. You got to put it off for the next year. I was like, nah, it's happening. Everybody was like, no, the bond smoker's a mess. You got it in Nicaragua. Why are you making it complicated? Why are you dragging it around and doing the whole thing? We got to get ready for our big European show. I was like, nah, it's happening. So, you know, when I was going through that, Jeff, come over here. When I was going through that, it was like all odds were against me. You know what I'm saying? The first bond smoker. It was everybody was tied up on the jurisdiction side. It was very, very hard. People were seeing it, but it wasn't clear. And you know what it kind of reminds me of? You guys know how big Corona Cigar Company is in Orlando and now in Tampa. You all know them, right? Guess what? It wasn't always like that. This guy had a little tiny cigar shop. It was like 1,000 square feet. It was a little ass shop. And Jeff had this vision for building out what you guys know today as Corona Cigar Company. And dude came to Nicaragua. It's where we really met. Yo, listen up! And talking about my man Jeff. You all need to pay attention for a second. So dude had this little shitty ass cigar shop. Believe me. And I remember one trip, he came to Nicaragua, and he had all these papers, blueprints. I never saw blueprints in my whole life. I never even seen them. There was blueprint after blueprint after blueprint. And he's showing me what Corona Cigar Company is gonna, the new Corona Cigar Company, what he's gonna build, this huge 5,000 or 6,000 square foot Corona Cigar Company world headquarters. Now remember, he had this little ass shop. And I remember everybody talking about Jeff, he's gonna go bankrupt. Jeff's lost his mind. Who the fuck does he think he is? Right or not? Everybody was like, not believing. But I said to my crew, I said, listen, at that time, whatever inventory came in from Nicaragua, it was very little bit. We got 100 boxes, 500 boxes, 300 boxes, whatever came into Miami. We didn't even need a warehouse. We just shipped it out. So I started stockpiling cigars for Jeff. And everybody was like, you're crazy. This dude's going to go out of business before he opens. No one would give him no money. No one would get him started, nothing. And I remember I drove up to see Jeff in a U-Haul. We filled that truck up. I drove that truck myself, that U-Haul, right or wrong. And I brought it up to Corona Cigar Company, and we set up the store. He proved everybody wrong. He proved everybody wrong. Because his vision was intact. His vision was deep, and his belief was strong. It's about following your dreams. And that's why I love Jeff so much, on top of the personal side, but as a businessman to businessman, as a visionary to a visionary, the dude is sincere, and he stands behind every single thing he did. So, you guys know every year, I fucking blabber on and on, but every year, you know, I talk about a theme that's kind of going through my heart and in my mind, my soul, at the time of every bond smoker. And some of them are interesting and some of them suck. But a couple of them were pretty good. You guys remember the fellowship? That was a good one. There was one about courage. There was one about, you know, about acceptance, being open-minded in life. But this one I came up with was something that I was feeling, was about, you guys know who Tupac is? Tupac Shakur, remember that name? Well, I'm not gonna say I agree and believe in everything anybody says, especially him. But when we came out with the brand, My Uzi Weighs a Ton, people were like, which brand is it? Is it Underground? Is it Acid? What brand is it? Liga Privada? I said, no, the name of the brand is My Uzi Weighs a Ton. And it was perplexing. It was like, why? Why would you name something My Uzi Weighs a Ton? It just didn't make sense, you know? And I kind of feel like this year I was playing this Tupac song, and that's going to be, for me, the personal theme of what this bond smoker is for me. And it's called You Ain't Shit Without Your Homeboys.
Yeah, yeah.
everyone knows one important thing in life, and that's you ain't shit without your homeboys. And I was like, man, there's so much truth in that, that the people in life that I'm so blessed, that I've surrounded myself with, and the people who've brought me into their lives. So for all of you guys who are here, who I got that with, and your homegirls, and your homeboys, and the people who make you who you are, and have give you the strength to push on, and to go against the odds, and to build something, my man Fabian, right? Those guys, to them, I dedicate this Bond Smoker to all my friends, and I dedicate this Bond Smoker to the people I love, and I dedicate this Bond Smoker to my homeboys and homegirls, because without you guys, Drew Estate would be the same bullshit that all this other bullshit is. So with that said, we're gonna have a good day today. I'm gonna wind up passing the mic right here back to my man Fabian. Thank you guys, love you guys. Let's have a great day.
All right, before we start, we got a couple of housekeeping things to do. Everyone has their phones, right? I need to see it up there. Come on, everybody. Everybody. Of pictures taken today. We want you guys to Instagram them, Facebook them, use the hashtag Barnsmoker, all right? We will pick two winners. One is a themed picture of you guys going to be planting your seedling in the field over there. There's going to be a little bit more to go in a second. So there's going to be one winner doing that. And then there's going to be another winner of just the best picture at FSG right here for a Barnsmoker. So take lots of pictures and tag, make sure you tag it with hashtag Barnsmoker. All right, last, everyone's got one. You see all these little flags, right? In the middle of your table. Make sure everyone grabs one of these flags and there should be some Sharpies on the table and you write your name on the flag. When you leave the tent, you gotta take your flag with you. The reason being is we are gonna be running a contest. Everyone is gonna go in the field over there at station one throughout the day, and they're gonna be planting their seedling in the field along with their little flag. And 90 days from now, the plant who has the biggest, the best looking leaves will actually win something. What is something? It's something, all right? It's something. You will win something. Put your email address on the back of your flag, all right? First name and email address, and I know there's gonna be like three people like, well, which one's the back of the flag? But the back of the flag is the side with your email on it, obviously, okay? All right, now the microphone's not gonna be grabbing, so I'm gonna yell for the rest of this stuff right here, right? So now this is how we're gonna do it.